Welcome to TraderMate tutorial. Today we'll show you how to pull live and historical Forex and CFD rates in Python using our software development kit. Simply head to TraderMate.com. Click on Join Data API for free. Sign up with your credentials. Head to Login. Once you've signed up, you will get a welcome email. Log in and you will be directed to my account page. You will be designated an API key as you can see here. You will need this to get market rates. Now open a Python terminal or your Python development environment that you prefer. We will use Google Colab for simplicity purpose. You'll first need to install the TraderMate library. To do that, type pip install TraderMate and press play. You can now see that we have installed TraderMate library with a single line of code. Ignore the error as these will not affect the performance of the library. If you're not comfortable with Google Colab, you can do the same command in any terminal where Python is installed. We can show you how to do this in VS Code. As we have already installed the library, we will be told that requirement already satisfied. But as you can see, you can run the same command on VS Code. We will now import the library. Press on code. And press shift enter. To make the command easier to follow, head back to your My Account. Click on Get Started Rest and click on Python SDK. Here you can find all the command that will follow in the tutorial. We'll simply copy paste the command that set our REST API key. We will now try to import live Forex rates into our notebook. Simply copy tm.live command. You can now see we have live rates. If you refresh this cell again, you will see that the rates have changed. Now, if you want to make changes to this live endpoint that gets us live rates, is fairly simple. Just change the currency pair you would like. If you do not want the mid, you can just take it off. You can now see we have bid ask rates for dollar yen and euro dollar. Now, in order to know what currency pairs are provided by TraderMate Data API, simply copy this command, tm currency list, and paste and run. You will be able to see what are the currency code that the API provides. The API also provides CFD rates. For that, the command is tm.cfdlist. You can see there's plenty of indices, commodities and stocks that you can get using this API. So far, we have seen how to get live rates, but it will be really useful to get historical rates. We will try to get a time series data in which we can get data for any currency for up to a few days back. To do that, head back again, copy the code that says time series. Now we would need to change the dates as the API only provides last 2 months of hourly historical. We will try to get hourly here. You can now see we have rates for euro dollar from 20th of September to 5th of October. Because our API returns a Pandas data frame, it's fairly easy to store this data in CSV or other formats. We will assign this to a variable. Now simply run df to CSV. You can now see the data is saved in a CSV file. If you're not using Google Colab, this will be in the same folder you're running the file from. Purpose of this video will stop here, but in future videos, we'll show you how to use this data to do powerful stuff. Thank you for following us.